We are a small community, just 5 square miles. The pride that our community has in their schools is its first and foremost. And that's evident by going into a school that's 100 years old. It's the education that's being delivered.
I think kids want to be in a place that looks nice. I think everybody wants to be in a place that looks nice, that works well.
Modernization of existing buildings is far more complicated than building new. There were some significant character-defining features that were heavily impacted by this structural seismic retrofit that needed to be completely taken down and replicated. It has to look like it was never touched. The most sustainable approach is to reuse an existing facility.
It was really important to the community to preserve the historical significance of El Rodeo, even though it would be more costly to do so.
We maintained all the patina and historical elements in the corridors, all the public spaces and in the theater and in the exterior of the building.
The two things that kept me up at night here at El Rodeo were this auditorium and the tower dome are so iconic that they just needed to be perfect. The pressure of having to replicate them exactly as they were, it's just a daunting task.
One of the things that is amazing about El Rodeo and part of this project is that the mural that's right outside of this auditorium was preserved. That's from the 30s as part of the New Deal and part of the painting and the artists that were funded as part of the New Deal. It makes our school part of history and part of American history.
The theater is a very special place. It is one of the spaces that most people remember. It's a significant piece of the cultural heritage of the school. If you can imagine the space, eliminate everything that you're looking at, and it's just a concrete shell. That's what it looked like a few years ago. And our job was to basically bring back every original detail that was here. The corbels, the trim molding, the mechanical vent grills, the replication of the seating, and of course the windows.
Somebody who graduated from that school in the 30s or in the 40s could literally walk into that theater today and it's going to look the same as it did when it was brand new in 1927.
All those light fixtures used to be on the surface of all these walls and the balcony, so it really created an eyesore. How do we tuck those away when they're not in use? So we came up with this custom line shaft that actually comes down all the way to the ground level so the theater production staff can replace light fixtures easily.
Because of the willingness of the design team to step in whenever needed and go above and beyond, what anybody normally would expect a design team to do, they did at every single turn.
This building is a physical representation of our collective talent and expertise. Our attention to detail and honoring the history of this project is just a reflection of our humanity and our integrity. We design for good. As architects, by nature, our profession is to advocate for the communities that we serve, the students, for the staff. And this project, I found myself becoming an advocate for the building as well. It was very important for us to pay homage to this incredible cultural resource.
If you think about it, this is going to be the start into the future, preparing kids for jobs that aren't even developed yet.
The building looks amazing. I'm so excited to start the first day of school. I can't wait for kids to come in and really make this place educational excellence.